हेलो डियर फ्रेंड्स, माय सेल्फ डॉक्टर राकेश कुमार त्रिपाठी एंड वी आर डिस्कसिंग अ वेरी स्पेशल टाइप ऑफ इंटीग्रल इन विच न्यूमरेटर इज डेरिवेटिव ऑफ डिनोमिनेटर. न्यूमरेटर इज डेरिवेटिव ऑफ डिनोमिनेटर. यू कैन सी हियर दैट differentiation of this f of x is in numerator f dash x. So numerator is derivative of denominator. So to integrate this kind of integral, we use to substitute t is equal to denominator, which you can see here. If I put t is equal to f of x, and whenever in means we put something in integration, we will have to differentiate at the same moment. So on differentiating left hand side, it is dt by dx, and right hand side will become f dash x. If I transfer this dx on right hand side becomes this dt is equal to f dash x dx. Means f dash x dx of this integral can be replaced by dt, which has been replaced here, and denominator will be replaced by t. So it is integral of dt by t. Now integral of 1 by t is, integral of 1 by t is log of t, whose base is e, or you can write ln, which will be read as ln t. And if you put value of t, it becomes ln fx, means ln fx. And if you use modulus, no harm in using modulus, because the most appropriate derivative of log of mod of x is 1 by x. So it was a general discussion about such kind of integral. Let's come to question now. Here there is a question. Question number 1, e to the power x upon e to the power x plus 1. You can see numerator is derivative of denominator. So on putting t is equal to denominator, and as I told you that whenever we put t is equal to denominator, we will have to differentiate at the same moment. So dt by dx will be e to the power x, and if I transfer dx on the right hand side, it becomes like this. Means this e to the power x dx can be replaced by dt, and denominator can be replaced by t. So dt by t, and you know integral of 1 by t is ln t or ln mod t, and now you can substitute value of t here. So after substituting value of t, which is e to the power x plus 1, the integral of given integral is this. And let's discuss few more questions on the basis of this kind of integral. Cot x, integral of cot x, which is cos x upon sin x, cos x upon sin x. You can see numerator is derivative of what? Denominator. So again you will apply the same procedure of putting t is equal to sin x, and as you put something, then you will differentiate that function on both the sides, so that it becomes dt is equal to dt by dx is equal to cos x, or dt is equal to cos x dx, and cos x dx can be replaced by dt, and again the same things, dt upon t, and integral of 1 by t is log t. So its integral is log sin x, whose base is e, or log of mod of sin x, no problem, or ln mod of sin x plus integral constant c. Similarly, the third integral, sin x by cos x, and you can see numerator is sin x and derivative of denominator is minus sin x. So I shall multiply inner side with this minus and outer with this minus, so that minus into minus becomes plus. Now again you will put t is equal to denominator, so that numerator becomes derivative of denominator, and the integral will be minus log of cos x whose base is e, or minus ln cos x. And as I told you, means hopefully it will be clear to you that there is an important property of log, minus ln x is equal to ln 1 by x. So if this minus will be inserted into log, then the function inside the log will invert itself, means cos x will become 1 by cos x, means this function will be inverted and it becomes 1 by cos x, and 1 by cos x is what? Sec x. So integral of this is ln sec x plus c, integral of tan x. And you will have to keep this as a formula in your mind. Let's come to question number 4, which is like this: integral of 1 upon x log x log log x. And you can see that derivative of log x is 1 upon x into 1 upon log x. So we shall put t is equal to log log x log log x, and if you differentiate this, derivative of log x is 1 by log x into derivative of log x is 1 by x, and this, therefore, this dx upon x log x will be replaced by dt, and denominator this log log x can be replaced by t, and dt upon t, integral of dt upon t is log t base e, or ln t, or ln t, because in this question we were already given log log log, that is why we used log. Or the question can be asked in this way: 1 upon x ln x ln x. The same question can be asked in with this notation. So its integral will be ln x plus c. Now let's come to a very important question, very very important question. This integral e to the power x minus 1 plus x to the power e minus 1, in which it is not very clear that numerator is derivative of denominator. So let's try to put t is equal to denominator. If I put t is equal to denominator, derivative of e to the power x is clear to you, it is e to the power x, but derivative of x to the power e will be same as derivative of x to the power n, and derivative of x to the power n is nx n minus 1, n into x to the power n minus 1, n is a constant, and in the same way e is a constant. So this formula should be applied here, and on taking e common, if I take e common, so here we do not have e, so in denominator we will have to write e, and he from this we have taken e common, and e if we transfer on left hand side and dx on right hand side, it becomes like this. And here e to the power x upon e to the power 1, we can apply law of indices, and according to law of indices this power will be transferred in numerator and it will become like this. So now this e to the power x minus 1 plus x to the power e minus 1 dx, this will be replaced by what? This will be replaced by dt by t, and this we have already substituted t, so it is t, 1 by e common, integral of log 1 by t is ln t, and on substituting value of t it is this. So you have experienced that how nice this question is. Now let's come to question number 6, which is this, and here you can see that numerator is not a derivative of denominator. So we will try to make numerator a derivative of denominator by multiplying and dividing both this means multiplying both numerator and denominator by e to the power minus x. If we multiply e to the power minus x in numerator, it becomes e to the power x. E to the power minus x into 1 becomes e to the power minus x. And similarly in denominator, we shall multiply e to the power minus x in both the terms, so that it becomes like this. Now you can see derivative of this is e to the power x, which is there. And derivative of e to the power minus x is e to the power minus x. And derivative of minus x is minus this. So again, you can apply the same procedure of putting t is equal to denominator, so that numerator becomes derivative of denominator. Your answer will be like this. So my good wishes with you. And I hope you will be able to integrate this. If you are observing it minutely, and in case if you have any kind of problem, do comment in comment box, or you can mail me drrakeshkumarthri Dr. Rakesh Kumar Tripathi @gmail.com. So this is my mail ID. You can mail me. Or if you wish to WhatsApp me, it's my WhatsApp number +91 96 856 98056. So there are three choices: comment, mail, or WhatsApp. So you can use any of these channels to contact. Let's come to question number 7, and this is an integral sine 2x dx upon this. Here let's try to put denominator is equal to t, and as we have put, we shall differentiate. Dt by dx, derivative of sine square x will be 2 sine x into derivative of sine x, and like here, derivative of cos square x, 2 cos x into minus sine x. Sine x, 2 sine x cos x is sine 2x, and lying in both, so sine 2x common, bracket will have a minus b. A minus b is a constant, can be transferred in denominator of left hand side, and we can transfer dx on right hand side, so that it becomes sine 2x dx. Numerator sine 2x dx can be replaced by what? It can be replaced by dt upon a minus b. Sine 2x dx can be replaced by dt upon a minus b, and denominator can be replaced by t. Numerator is already having something in denominator, but denominator is not having, so we can put 1 in denominator. 1 will be multiplied with this, and t will be with this. A minus b can be taken common, being a constant, and integral will be dt by t, whose integral is ln mod t. And now on substituting value of t, this is like this, and finally this is your answer of the given question. Let's come to integrate another integral, a very important integral. It was asked in CBSE 2015, and before this year it was not in any of the reference books which I could saw, and neither it was in NCRT nor in exemplar. So the question is this: sin x minus x cos x upon this. To integrate this, this is a very special type of integral. We shall take x common from this, and if we take x common from this, then sin x doesn't have x in multiplication, so it will become sin x by x. X into this x will become x square, and you can see here sin x minus x cos x upon x square, and this is 1 plus sin x by x. On substituting 1 plus sin x by x as t, we shall have to differentiate now. As I told you, dt by dx will be derivative of 1 0, and here we shall apply quotient rule. So denominator square, denominator as it is, derivative of sin x cos x, sin x numerator as it is, derivative of denominator means derivative of x is 1, And here in the integral, it is sin x minus x cos x, but here we have x cos x minus sin x. So we will take minus common so that it becomes like the integral. And now it has become like the integral and dt by dx in left hand side. We will transfer dx on right hand side and minus in left hand side. Therefore, this whole portion will be replaced by minus dt, and denominator will become t. This 1 plus sin x by cos x will become t, and minus common, integral of t, 1 by t is as usual ln t, and if I insert this minus inside, it becomes log ln 1 by t, and on substituting value of t, it becomes this, and naturally it should be solved further. So it becomes ln x upon x plus sin x plus c. Question number 9, a very important integral, 1 upon x to the power n plus 1, which is a very popular question, and you can see many integrals in which values of n will be changed. Sometimes n will be 2 by 3, sometimes n will be 6, 2, 3, 5, like this. So such kind of integral can be integrated by taking x to the power n common. So if I take x to the power n common, it is denominator is having x to the power 1. So x to the power n, when we take common, it becomes x to the power n plus 1. And here this bracket will be x to the, since we have taken common x to the power n, it becomes 1, and here we don't have x to the power n, so denominator will have x to the power n now, and differentiating this by putting t is equal to this, on differentiating this, dt by dx will be like this. And I advise you to learn this integral. You know ddx of x to the power n is known to you, nx to the power n, nx to the power n minus 1. But ddx of 1 by x to the power n, you don't keep in mind. So I advise you to keep this as a result in your mind, so that it will save your time and will increase your confidence level. So it's like this, and you can differentiate this if you wish to differentiate it without using this formula, or without considering this as a formula, you can use this concept. Ddx of 1 by x to the power n is same as ddx of x to the power minus n, which will be same as this. So dx now on right hand side, minus n on left hand side. Dx upon x to the power n plus 1 will be replaced by this, dt upon minus n, and this can be replaced by t, and denominator can be made complete by putting 1 in denominator. This 1 will be multiplied with dt, and t will be minus n. 1 upon minus n can be taken common, being a constant. Again, integral of dt by t is this, ln t, value of t is this. If you insert this minus, then this will become its reciprocal, inverse. And on the basis of this question number 9, I ask you to solve these three questions, 9a, 9b, and 9c. 9c is not so direct. This should be reduced in the given form, in the form of question number 9, by writing this as this. X square plus 2x plus 2. You can write x square plus 2x plus 1 plus 1. X square plus 2x plus 1 will be x plus 1 whole square. Now you can take x plus 1 whole square common and put 1 plus 1 by x plus 1 whole square as t, and your answer will be this, 1 upon 2 ln x plus 1 square upon x square plus 2x plus 2. No harm if we use modulus. Question number 10. In this question, we might think that numerator is derivative of denominator, but it is not like that, because derivative of sin 3x is 3 cos 3x, but here we have only cos 3x. So to integrate this, we will have to use cos c minus cos d, and cos c minus cos d is minus 2 sin c plus d by 2 sin c minus d by 2. And similarly, in denominator, it is sin c minus sin d, which is 2 cos c plus d by 2 and sin c minus d by 2. So, on applying these two formulas, we find like this, minus 2 sin 3x plus x by 2, sin 3x minus x by 2. And in denominator, 2 cos 3x plus x by 2 and sin 3x minus x by 2. These two are same, can be cancelled. 2 cancel, minus. It has become sin 2x upon cos 2x. Don't write it tan 2x. Put t is equal to cos 2x and differentiate it. Its derivative will be dt by dx minus 2 sin 2x. Transfer dx on right hand side and minus 2 in denominator, so that it becomes like this. Sin 2x dx can be replaced by dt by minus 2, and cos 2x is t. This minus 1 by 2 common, so this minus minus becomes plus 1 by 2 ln integral of 1 by t ln cos t, and value of t is cos 2x. And you know why we are using modulus, because the most appropriate derivative of ln mod x is 1 by x. And if you wish to know more about integrals, then please let me know. I have given you my both things, WhatsApp number and my mail ID. Comment section is already for you. You may write. I used to access comments regularly. My best wishes with you. And I am Dr. Rakesh Kumar Tripathi, PhD in Mathematics, awarded with many international and national organizations, and a most prestigious award for one of my research papers in mathematics in 101st Indian Science Congress, Jammu. I was awarded by the Vice President of India in 2014. So my good wishes with you, and wish you all the best for keeping so much patience and for learning so many things. My best wishes with you. All the best.